What are these other challenges, actually? Alright, so all I need to do is just use sideways weapons, essentially, is what they're just telling me to do. So this, I just need to have a sideways minigun. It's essentially what I need to have. Really interesting. Yeah, I can say that, but I don't Wait, what? They're destroying car. Wait, there are mechanical parts in this game? Say no, it's capped. There ain't no way. I don't believe it. A small cap. There ain't no mechanical parts in this game. What do you mean? What is it? Time for... Oh shit, AP calculus, that's interesting.
That is... Oh wait, is that my cat? Oh no, that's my cat. I thought I called my own. My own cat is named
Sophie. Sophie, I understand. I mean, I didn't understand what you said first time, but I thought it was something I couldn't pronounce. Dude, I have mine too. Indian here. All right, guys. So I want to go on and introduce something that's called the product rule today. So yesterday we were dealing with derivatives. We started dealing with derivatives using the power rule. So I hope that somebody can help me with the first question and see what's going to happen with number two. I have very few students here though, so I'm going to try to call them individually. And I don't remember, I don't have the same attendance record that I had yesterday, so I don't remember who told me that they'd taken the test today. Deep you here, right? I saw more absent. Oh, Madeline. I did not see you signing in. Your sister here? Guys, again, if there's anybody who just picked up the phone or anybody who signed in a little later, please let me know, because I only have one laptop in front of me right now. So once they start projecting my screen, I'm not going to be looking at the chat, okay? So far, I was looking at the number of people here. I was trying to call the ones that are not here. Hey, Wendy, I see that you joined. Angelina, okay. All right, so let's get started and hopefully more people will sign in as we talk in. Wendy. All right. Okay, and I completely forgot that I didn't start sharing my screen. This was one of my issues at the beginning of remote screen teaching, so I apologize. You know, thinking you're already done with the two questions and getting bored. All right, so yesterday we started talking about the power rule. Did somebody help me to figure out the derivative of function f? The first question. Well, it's going to be the f prime of x. Neha, can you help me? All right, I can see that many are already working on the assignment that I have on Delta Med. I didn't even go over it, so I guess that you looked at the videos. So in number one, I had a function f was given, f of x was defined as x to the 6th power plus x to the 3rd. We're supposed to figure out the derivative. Randy, can you help me? Because I need to hear you. You sign in, but I'm calling on you and you're not responding. I'm going to mark you absent. Somebody's raising their hand. Neha, yes? Oh.
6x to the fifth plus 3x to the second.
Excellent. 6x, can you explain?
So you multiply 6 by 1 because there's a 1 in front of x.
Mm-hmm.
And you minus the exponent by 1, so you get 5. And then you multiply 3 by 1, so you get 3x. And then you minus 3 by 1 to get the exponent 2.
Excellent. Wonderful. Now, what do you think? Can we do the same thing for number 2? So far, I only introduced the power rule, and I've said yesterday that it will work for polynomials because those are actually a bunch of binomials separated by plus and minus signs. But in number 2, I get the multiplication, so that's a little different, right? So one way that you can do number 2 here is to simplify and rewrite the f of x. Yes. Does anybody remember what we do with the exponents when we multiply the powers with the same base? Okay, so we add them. So instead of writing x to the power of 6 times x to the power of 3, I can rewrite this as x to the power of 6 plus 3, which is x to the 9. And now if I apply the same power rule, I'll see that this would be equal to 9x to the 8th power. In the meantime, if you try to do some kind of something similar to what we did before, if you had the 6x to the 5th plus times 3x squared, you would end up with a completely different answer. All right? So what's going on here? When you have the product of two functions, you're going to have to use something that's called a product rule. I'll just let you copy the formula here. So when you're multiplying two functions and taking the derivative, what we're going to do is take the derivative of the first function, multiply by the second one, plus keep the first function, multiply by the derivative of the second one. So in that question that I had before, when I had the x to the sixth power times x to the third, to take the derivative of this, we do, again, derivative of the first function. So derivative of x to the 6th power is 6x to the 5th, and I'm keeping the second function, right, x to the 3rd, plus I keep the first function, which is x to the 6th, times the derivative of the second, which is 3x squared. And now let's see what we can simplify. So from the first part, I got 6. And again, you multiplied x to the 5th power times x to the 3rd, so this would be 6 to the 8th power plus 3x to the 8th. And now, because I have the same power times exponents, you can add them up, so I end up with 9x power, which is the same thing as we got before when we found the product first, right? Are there any questions? So what do you say? Shall we do these two together, or you guys want to try on your own? I guess we can do two questions together because you're going to have some practice on delta math. So example number 1, I got y function y equals cube root of x squared times blah blah blah. I don't like the people of X squared, so I'm gonna rewrite that first function x to the power of 2/3. Easier for me to work that way times, and the second function is 2x minus x squared. Right? Now, if you want me to write this separately, step by step, I could rewrite this as, well, we're gonna do the derivative of x to the power of 2/3. Okay? The derivative times, I'm gonna keep the second function, 2x minus x squared plus. Now we're gonna keep the first function, which was x to the power of 2/3, and multiply that by the derivative of the second one, which is, I'm just gonna use the derivative notation first. So again, this is the prime. So let's do this step by step. When I take the derivative of x to the power of 2/3, we get 2/3 x to the power of -1/3. And I still have times 2x minus x squared plus x to the power of 2/3 times now the derivative of the second function, that's just gonna be 2 minus 2x. And let's see if we can. So I would still go on, and because the original function had the radical in it, I would rewrite my answer, the final answer, using the radical as well. And I'm gonna say that we're gonna end up with y prime being equal to 2 times 2x minus x squared, where we could definitely distribute here, over 3 times cube root of x plus cube root of x squared times 2 minus 2x. Sorry about writing it this way. And most of your delta math questions say write the derivative in any form, because again, over here I could distribute or now. Okay. So you're allowed to rewrite the answers in different ways. Are there any questions, comments about example number one? No? All right. Does anybody want to do number two or help me to do number two? We don't need to do three. I'm just leaving more space. Unless you want me to. All right. So, again, to find the derivative of function f of x, you have to write a formula. I can do it here. So when we have the product of two functions, to take the